You already know it's your favorite boy, King Zeb, and I'm from Short Lips TV. I'm on the street of Lagos, and I'm doing what I know how to do best. That's what's up. We the youth have been one of the set of people that have been using the internet. A lot of things have been done on the internet today. But well, to everything that has got an advantage has also got a disadvantage. So the question today is, in your own opinion, do you think that the internet has shaped the youth of today in a positive or negative way? Wow. While you are watching, let me take you on the ride. That's what's up. In your own opinion, do you think that the internet has shaped the youth of our today in a positive or negative way?
I think the internet has shaped our youth in a positive way, generally. I must confess, I think it's in a positive way. It doesn't really matter if some youth are using the internet in a negative way. I think that number is very small, and the majority of Nigerians actually are using the internet in a very positive way. Because effectively, applications like WhatsApp, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter are major tools that has helped our youth to learn more and to develop more in several areas. As things are now, there is absolutely nothing you want to learn now that you cannot learn on the internet and learn for free. You know, so I think we have a very good thing in the internet. And for Nigerians, it has been a blessing, I must say.
Well, I would say that yes, of course, the internet has shaped the lives of the youth in a positive way. Because human beings generally are dynamic and life is really transitional. So since technology develops, the youths too should meet up. So one way or the other, you find out that technology has to help people really live their lives. Look at the traffic in Lagos right now. With your Google map, you get to where you want to get to. You know that, okay, this route I'm about to apply is better. That route is not good and stuff like that. So all of those things, yes, one must say that, yes, indeed, technology has really shaped the lives of generally people and then the youth, to be more specific.
The internet in itself is not bad, nor is it good. Yeah. It's the usage that determines the way it turned out to be. So I think it's dicey. It's a two-way, it's a coin. There are two sides to the story. For the one side, the internet has shaped on the lives of the youth positively. On the other side, negatively. Okay, positively could be in the essence of maybe business-wise, now people have used that opportunities to learn and then to help themselves make money. That's one side. And then the other side is, of course, you know about cybercrime and then cyberterrorism massive. So it's like two sides of a coin. Depends on which side you face and all.
Generally speaking, the internet has done a lot of good in terms of research work, educational aspects. That's really helped. Gone were those days when you have to go to the library or buy a book before you can gain knowledge or information. You know, now you can, at the comfort of your room, anywhere you are, you can always gather information to do whatever you want to do, you know.
Definitely, it has affected the youth positively. And even though you look at the negative side, the positive aspect is overweigh the negative aspect. Because there's more awareness to the youth. There's kind of sensitization, passing information easily from one person to the other. Even though there are situations that are worse than what we are experiencing now, the youth are updoing. They can communicate easily with the internet and be able to tell the government this is what they feel. It is something that we are fighting. Maybe when it comes to election, we see that we can say something, the youth can say something on the aspect of who to elect. And now we know who to elect, who we don't want. It's as easy as that.
It has gone a long way to help the youth, those that knows what they are doing. Though, like me as a businessman, whatever I do, like I'm going to work right now, whatever I do, I post it on the internet. It goes viral. I don't have to go start telling people on site I'm doing this. I just do it. After doing my work, I post it and people see what I do and they like it. They call on me to come and do what I'm doing. So I believe it has gone a long way to help the youth and it will keep helping us.
It shaped us in a negative and positive way. We use internet for different things. It depends on what you want to use the internet for. You can go online to search for ideas of businesses. You can go online to search for answers to your assignments. You can go online to watch porn. I feel it depends on what you want to do on the internet. It depends on what your intention is when you're going on the internet.
Actually, it has helped us in so many areas, like in areas of technology. These days, you discover that within a twinkle of an eye, the internet have taken information so far. So that's one of the ways it has helped us in the area of technology. that really helped us in that area.
People can actually make money from the comfort of their homes. This has to do with we bringing our knowledge to social media, making sure that social media is something that we have to pay attention to. If you talk about digital marketing today, you can't do digital marketing in your house, just sleeping, or you can't do it in your office. It has to do with something with your phone and all those stuff, like your laptop, your gadget and all. So a lot. Social media has helped us to see things that generally we can only see it on the news, but now we can see it on different hard. On just go to your Instagram today, you see a lot of hard. Go to your LinkedIn today, you see a lot of job opportunities and all those things. Before, we need to wait for newspaper, or we're looking for one fax to send one fax that there's one job employment. So social media has actually helped.
Actually, it has really shaped both positive and negative way, because at some point some persons get into the YouTube and they go in for something funny and they learn immoral things there. Another point, you see some other persons checking it and learning some moral. Especially when there are fake news, somebody takes this news up and sends it to either WhatsApp or via whatever channels, and this news gets people infuriated already and gets them feel uncomfortable. Even sometimes it affected me. I was even telling somebody, oh, June 24, something's going to happen. A neighbor of mine even wedded that same day. Behold, I was even at the wedding, but I was scared, thinking there was going to be, a disruptancy and protest. But behold, nothing happened. So I felt why all this, whatever I saw on the WhatsApp, telling us that don't go out. So they even made it in a broken way that you shouldn't even go out. If you go out, they will kill you, they will do that. Yeah. But I found that nothing happened. All these things are just false stories. These are fictitious and fallacious statements that they just post on the internet, Twitter, YouTube, WhatsApp, name it all. So it's shaped both positively and negatively. That's my take. Thank you.
It has helped, but you know, it has gone to an extent that people are taking advantages of it. Like, as I speak to you now, I've been scammed, and it's through the internet. So it has helped a lot of people, but at the same time, it's ruining lives, like, seriously. That's the best I can say so far.
The internet have shaped the youth of today in both positive and negative way. And the aspect of negative way is that some youth use the internet in the aspect of abusing and also racism. In the positive way, people use it to do research and also get information. So let's say into places and also news.
Well, my personal opinion about that is that it's in the negative forms. In our own time, we don't have access to that, and the criminalities were not so rampant like this. But now you see, even at a child is even exposed to internet, and you learn a lot of things from that. Instead of sitting at the feet of the elders, but they now sit at the feet of the internet, learn so many things. So that's my personal opinion.
Impact, yes, to a large extent, it really does. But of course, everything that has positive value, of course, to some extent too, has some negativity. So you ask me, the positive side, maybe it's 5%, on the negative, 15%. My view.
I think it's both ways, both positive and negative. If you look around, you see we are all addicted to our phones and, of course, the internet. So I think individually, it depends on what you want to pick on the internet. For me, I look for opportunities, business opportunities, and how to network and grab every opportunity there to make money. But for other persons, you wouldn't say, you know, there are so many things flying around on the internet, agendas and all kind of stuff. So it's both ways. Okay. It's both ways.
Depends on your personal person you get. Some people are using it in a positive way. Some are using it in a negative way. So it's just like, basically for everything that we do in life, you know, there'll always be the good side and the bad side. So it now depends on you. You are going to make the good outweigh the bad, or the bad outweigh the good. So that's just it.
Yes, manager people, we've come to the end of this segment, and I hope you enjoyed yourself as much as I did. You heard how Nigerians actually reacted to the questions, and we all know that what has got an advantage also have a disadvantage. So right about now, if you love my content and you want to continue seeing more of this content on your screen, I'll beg you all to please go subscribe to our YouTube channel at Shortlived TV, also on Instagram at Shortlived TV. Do not forget to sign up to our anonymous website at www.theshortlist.com, a platform where you can discuss any issue at all without putting a face or a name to it. And the best part about it is that no topic is limited. You can ask anything. You can bring any issue or topic to the table. Until I come your way next time, you already know it's your favorite boy, King Zeb. And that's what's up.